Hello, I'm Steve Forbes, and this is What's Ahead. We give you insights and perspectives to stay on top of what's happening in this ever-turbulent world, and also glimpses into the future. Right now, people more and more want to know. Now that these rescue packages have been passed, and another one perhaps is on the way, they want to know is, when is the economy going to get back open again? When can they get back to work and do productive things instead of hoping for relief until they can get back to work? Well, a key part of it is finding out who can go back into the workforce, and there are tests out there to do it. They can test for antibodies. Experts estimate, amazingly, that one half to three quarters of the people who have had this virus may not have known it. And so if we can find out who they are, get them back in the workforce, the better off all of us will be. There are tests already being done. Germany plans a lot of them. Britain is planning millions of them. In this country, 40 companies are ready to go, but many of them are holding back. Why? Because they want formal FDA approval because they fear crippling lawsuits. Well, the answer is very simple. The solution is very simple, and that is give these companies with proven records of reliability, proven records of safety, give them limited liability. In fact, remove all liability for this particular test and get on with it. The sooner, the better. Talking about getting the economy moving, there's talk about a $2 trillion infrastructure package may be coming. Well, if we move ahead on big infrastructure programs, let's do there what we've been doing with testing, streamline it. Right now, a bridge that normally would take 2 years to build from beginning to end now takes 10 years. A lot of unnecessary rules and regulations. Get rid of them. Streamline it. That should be a condition. States want infrastructure money. By golly, make it simple so we get these things done in months and not long years. Now, in terms of the oil industry, devastated by what's happening, both by what's happened to the closing of the global economy and the war with Russia and Saudi Arabia over pricing, President Trump is meeting with these people tomorrow. And what should come out of it is this. In terms of Russia, Putin wants to destroy our fracking industry. So do the Saudi Arabians. Putin also wants removal of sanctions, particularly on his largest oil company. We should send a message to Vladimir, and that is this. Stop the price war. Otherwise, we're going to double it, triple it. And on the political front, Andrew Cuomo, the hero governor of New York, said on Monday he is not interested in running for president. But everyone knows if you're interested in the presidency, you don't announce it until the time is ripe. And Joe Biden certainly has not done anything to show people that he would be a more forceful candidate than Andrew Cuomo. The Democrats have already moved their convention. They announced it today from July to August. That gives more time for Democrats to wonder, is there a better candidate out there? And there's one in Albany ready to go, even if he doesn't admit it. So I'm Steve Forbes. Thank you very much for listening, and look forward to talking to you soon again.